Welcome back students. So in this class we shall start the last chapter of this volume 1, chapter 10. Okay, means the second chapter of data structure. The first chapter of data structure is completed and I hope you understood, and if you any doubt you can ask me. So in this class we shall start chapter 10. Okay, chapter 10 means we have to be study linked list and stack. Q is deleted from a syllabus for this year. Okay, mainly in this chapter we have to study linked list in detail of linked list, stack and Q. But Q is deleted for this year. Okay, because I hope you know 30% of your syllabus is cut by the council, so Q is under that 30%. Okay, Q is deleted. We have to be study detail in linked list and stack, and means stack means application stack, etc. Okay, so first of all we have to be study linked list. Okay, so what is linked list? You already know linked list. I told you in the previous class. Linked list means linked list is a dynamic data structure. Okay, means in this we have, at the time of execution we have to be, either we have add a new value or delete the new value. Means you see, what is the difference between array and linked list? It is frequently asked, it is frequently coming that type of questions or asked in your Viva also, external sometimes asked in practical Viva, that what is the difference between array and linked list. Array is what? Array is static data structure. Means when we define an array, suppose this is array A5 0 1 2 3 4, means it is static. We have to be first define this memory. Okay, after that suppose we have consume only 3 4, we have only allocate only 4 memory location of this. Means this is what? This is wasted. This is wasted and this will never be deleted. Means this memory will be what? Wasted memory. Or if suppose we want to add or new value, means this will not happen because we have to be add only 5, because we declare 5. Means in array, when we declare a memory size, means you have to be insert only that number of element. Okay, you cannot be able to insert more element that of the memory, or you cannot be add the element in the execution time. It will be constant at a compile time. Okay, it will be declare at compile time. You cannot be able to insert or delete the element in the execution time. But this problem will be overcome by linked list, because in linked list we can insert at the time of, you know, execution, or even delete at the time of execution. Means it is dynamic. It is dynamic, and this is static. Means this, in this memory will be constant, but in this memory will be not constant. Memory will be dynamic, variety, variable. We can add. Suppose we have to be add 8 number of element, then we allocate only 8. Okay, none of the memory will be wasted or, you know, overflow. It will be flexible. Okay, in this linked list we can add or delete, insert or delete at any time, means at the execution time. But in array it is not possible, but in here it is possible. Okay, so first of all we have to be study the definition. The details note will be provided in the book, you can study by yourself. I don't give you note, I just write the definition. Linked list is a linear connection data element linear collection of data elements comma called nodes pointing to the next nodes pointing to the next nodes by means of pointers. By means of pointers, you see, linked list is a linear collection of data elements called nodes pointing to the next nodes by means of pointers. Means, see, in linked list, there is a starting pointer. Okay, and that is called start. After that, you see, this is totally called node, and this part contain information, means element, and this part contain memory address of the next element. Okay, you see, suppose there is 5 node. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And suppose this is the element 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So this part is called info, and this part contain the memory address of this element. See, suppose memory address of all the value will be this. Means, you see, the start pointer stores the memory address of this. Means start stored 1001. This contain this memory. 1003. This contain this. 1005. This contain this. 7. This contain this. 1009. And this contain null. Why null? Because there is no node beyond this. This is the last node. For the last node, it will contain the memory address of null, because there is no node after that. Okay, and in the starting pointer, it will contain the first memory address of the memory address of the first node. Overall, a node contain info plus memory address of next node, and this is called node. Means node means it is contain two part. One first part is contain information, means element, any element, integer, character, float, any type. And next part contain memory address of next node. Means this contain memory address of this node, this contain memory address of this, this contain memory address of this, like that. And last one is contain null, because there is no memory address after that. And start contain this starting memory address. Okay, this is the basic concept of linked list, and it is called singly linked list. Singly linked list, actually. Doubly means also both direction. Circular linked list, okay. In a syllabus, mainly singly linked list is you have to be study. Doubly linked list, circular linked list, this is not in your syllabus, okay. If you study detail in engineering or graduation in computer science, then you obtain the thing. Doubly linked list, circular linked list, but in class 12 in your syllabus only singly linked list will be enough for you. Okay, so you see, next part one topic will coming, and that topic we discuss, but that topic is very important for a final exam also. Some difference will be coming, memory allocation, static versus dynamic. Okay, this difference will be coming. That's why I write down. स्टैटिक मेमोरी एलोकेशन, यू जस्ट राइट डाउन दिस मेमोरी एलोकेशन टेक्निक रिजर्व्स दिस मेमोरी एलोकेशन टेक्निक्स रिजर्व्स फिक्स्ड अमाउंट ऑफ मेमोरी फिक्स्ड अमाउंट ऑफ मेमोरी बिफोर एक्चुअल प्रोसेसिंग टेक्स प्लेस बिफोर एक्चुअल प्रोसेसिंग टेक्स प्लेस ओके कॉमा देयरफॉर नंबर ऑफ एलिमेंट्स देयरफॉर नंबर ऑफ एलिमेंट्स टू बी स्टोर्ड मस्ट बी प्रीडिटरमाइंड टू बी स्टोर्ड must be predetermined. This is the concept, predetermined. It will be predetermined at a time of compile time. Such type of memory allocation is called स्टैटिक मेमोरी एलोकेशन एंड दिस एग्जाम्पल इज मेनली एरे एरे इज एलोकेटेड मेमोरी यूजिंग दिस टेक्निक ओनली एरेज आर एलोकेटेड मेमोरी यूजिंग दिस टेक्निक ओनली using this technique you see what is static memory allocation this memory allocation techniques reserve fixed amount of memory I told you already when we declare array suppose int a 10 or two dimensional I take a 10 10 means we have to be insert how many maximum number of element 100 means 10 by 10 means this is matrix concept I show you in two dimensional means a 10 10 means we have to be insert maximum 100 element we have to be not neither we have to be able to insert 101 or 102 element because this will be fixed this will be declared at the time of compile time means at the time of when we done the coding part right we cannot be able to expand this in the time of run time or execution time okay this is the concept fixed amount of memory before actual processing takes place therefore number of elements to be stored must be predetermined we have to predetermine this that we can be able to insert maximum 100 element or suppose if we insert only 80 elements means 20 element memory will be wasted this is the concept so such type of memory allocation is called static memory allocation arrays are elaborate memory using this technique only right and next is dynamic memory allocation this difference will be frequently coming in exam okay that's why I write down this is very very important okay I mark here important next is dynamic memory allocation this memory allocation technique this memory allocation technique facilitates allocation of memory facilitates okay this is c एसीलेट्स एलोकेशन ऑफ मेमोरी ड्यूरिंग द प्रोग्राम एग्जीक्यूशन इटसेल्फ व्हाट आई सेड अर्लियर ड्यूरिंग द प्रोग्राम एग्जीक्यूशन इटसेल्फ राइट एज एन व्हेन रिक्वायर्ड मीन्स व्हेन रिक्वायर्ड एज एन व्हेन रिक्वायर्ड राइट दिस टेक्निक्स ऑफ मेमोरी एलोकेशन इज कॉल्ड This technique of memory allocation is called dynamic memory allocation. लास्ट लाइन यू हैव राइट डायनामिक मेमोरी एलोकेशन ऑल्सो फैसिलिटेट्स डायनामिक मेमोरी एलोकेशन ऑल्सो फैसिलिटेट्स ऑल्सो फैसिलिटेट्स रिलीज ऑफ मेमोरी इफ मेमोरी Release of memory if memory is not required anymore. Not required anymore, right? And we have like linked and trees are not required in your syllabus. The linked list and trees are. Trees are under this memory allocation techniques. Technique. Okay. You see, I mean this memory allocation technique. Facilitates allocation of memory during the program execution itself. Okay, as and when required. This technique of memory allocation is called dynamic memory allocation. Dynamic memory allocation also facilitates release of memory. Memory is not required anymore. Linked list and trees are under this memory allocation technique. You see, means we already discussed in dynamic memory allocation. We can add. Or we can delay it means release of memory at a time of execution. Suppose if we declared a linked list of suppose five memory storage, okay? But we consume only four. We insert only four element. Okay. We insert only four element. Then the last memory will be what? Was that so that this that memory will be released at the time of execution, right? Or suppose we declare five memory storage, but we have to be insert six element. Then we can add one extra memory at the time of execution. That type of flexibility means dynamicity. That's why it is called dynamic memory allocation. This is dynamic allocation also facilitates release of memory if memory is not required anymore. And linked list and trees are under this technique. Linked list is mainly we have to study. Trees are not your syllabus. It is be obtained in the far future if you study detail in computer science. Okay, this is a memory allocation, very important. So now we have to study some concept of you see So there is suppose, you know, this is suppose we have to particle array, okay? I just give you the concept. Detail note will be in your books, you study 0 to 9, means 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 9 and 10. This is suppose info part, means first part of the node. And this is the next link, okay? This is also 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. We have to give the index. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 8, 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Right. You see, we shall start from this is the start, okay? And start if pointing to this means start contains 6. This is the memory address 6. Okay. So we give the element, suppose character element L R E C J E and V. Right. So this will be link. Link means suppose this is a node, okay? This is a node. So this node contain what? First part is called info and second part is called link. Link or pointer. Same thing, link or pointer. Means point to the next node. Means it store, this part store what? Memory address of next node. I already show you, right? So in these two vertical array, first part of array contain information part and second part of array contain link part. And starting is the starting pointer. The starting pointer store the what memory address of this E6, right? So in here you see from the start point, suppose we coming in this R means what will it this in here? It will contain this memory address too. Okay, you just got it. When we pointed from this to this R, this part contain the memory address of this two, because it pointed to the this node, and this node the memory address of two, that's why it is two, okay? And after that, suppose this 3 to S means this contain 3, okay? No, not this part, this part. Okay, 3. Okay, also you can point it from this also, but I draw the diagram from the book, that's why I write exactly. And 4 to this means it will contain 0. And lastly, 6 to this is 4. 4 means this. And 7 contain 1. 1 means it will go to this. Okay, don't be confused, because okay, suppose this link is 2 means it will contain the 2 number of node address this in pointed in here. 1 means it will pointed to the this here. Okay, this is the concept. Okay, next one concept I show you, and that concept is called garbage collection. Okay, why it is called garbage collection? Because one extra node is available. I show you. Suppose there is a two vertical array, okay? 0 to 9, 0 to 9, okay? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Also, this is a part. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 1, 2, okay. 10. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Right. This is info part, this is link. In here, one extra concept is coming. You see, in start, start contain the memory address of what? 6. This is 6, means it is pointed to the 6. Right. And one concept, I show you avail. Avail pointer means available. First of all, I write down the note L R S R S J E V. Okay. So first it will be 2, means it is pointed to the this. Second is 9, means it is pointed to this. Third is 3, 7. 3 means it is pointed to here. 7 means it will pointed to here. After that, it is 0. 0 means it will go to the first node of the address, okay? And after that, you see, this is minus 1. I told you, 4 minus 1, 4 means it will go to here. Minus 1, 1, 8. You see. One means it will go to the this part in one, and this is 5, okay, not 8. This is 5. This will go to the mainly this here. You see, in here, how many free memory? This will be free memory. 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 Means 4 free memory will be available. And that 4 free memory will be available by this pointer. Means first available is point to 8. 8 means here. Why it will contain 8? Because 8 is free memory. You see, this is free memory. These two, both two are free memory. These two are free memory and these two are free memory. That's why the free memory is contained by this pointer available. And storing the free memory, okay? And storing the free memory, you see, the line will be right, the notes will be given in your book, the garbage line, don't provide a note, I just give you the concept. The collection of free notes in avail is called garbage collection, right? Okay, detail notes will be in the book, you write down. Means available, this avail pointer to the free node, okay? That's why I give you this concept. And minus 1 means it will contain nothing, because minus 1 is not here. Minus 1, this pointer will be, this will be actually zero pointer, means you can say null pointer. Means this is not happening, because minus 1 is not here. Okay, that's why it is pointed to nothing. It is allocated, but it is pointed to nothing. You see, from this point, there is no pointer. Nowhere to point. Why? Because this minus 1 is not possible. Okay? Remaining, you see. If you see properly, free memory storage is what? 1, 5, 8 is not here, 9. So, if I clearly show you, means, say this will be contained in here, this will be contained in here, and this will be contained in here. You see, means 9 is coming in here, this will be blank, 5 is also blank, 1 is also blank. Means this and 8 is also contained by available. Means 8 is contained by available pointer. This free will be contained by this memory address will be contained by this with respect to 1. This free memory address is contained by this with respect to 9. And this free memory will be contained by this. It's memory address 8. But After that, first of all, avail pointer contain 8. And after if it contain the 9, this 9 is also free. After if contain also 5 and 1 means collection of free nodes in avail is called, this is called garbage collection. Okay, you just write the definition in books. Okay, in books it is written that with every insertion avail points to its next node, and with every deletion avail points to the freed node, and next pointer of the freed node points to the previous first avail node. The method of adding free nodes in avail list is called garbage collection. Okay, you just read from the properly note, then you can easily understand by yourself. Okay, and if you any doubt you can ask me. So this will be enough for this session. Okay, and I again tell you, this avail concept is clearly written in the book. Okay, I don't give you the note, I just give you the concept. Here read, you make the note by yourself. Okay, and if you any doubt you can ask me. So in next class we shall start the algorithm part of the insertion of a linked list, means insertion in a single linked list. Okay, thank you.